bass trombone with the Atlanta Symphony Orchestra and am artist in residence at Kennesaw State University. I wanted to talk to you a little bit today about buzzing, why we do it, and how it helps us in the long run on the trombone. I start every single practice session with at least 20 minutes of buzzing, or in my terms, four songs. I buzz a lot to pop music, to country music, to really kind of anything that's in my head. I'm an awful singer, so instead of singing aloud to songs that are in my head, I get my mouthpiece out and I buzz along to them. I rarely start with just the mouthpiece. I usually have some sort of a device that I help give me just a little bit of resistance. I know some people have talked about adding the pinky towards the end. That can work, but then you're just kind of spitting all over your pinky. So I use this shortened lead pipe a lot in my car, also whenever I'm just walking around the room. A couple other devices that I've used in the past and I still think are great are a full lead pipe, also a plastic tube here that you use for some household plumbing items. You can find it at Home Depot for very cheap. Anyways, for today, we'll just focus on, I'm gonna use this shortened 2-inch lead pipe here. Whenever I start buzzing and I get my mouthpiece out of the case, my horn is still in the case, I haven't even put it together, but I wanna focus on just getting the lips buzzing, just getting them moving. And I usually pick a song to sing with them, and it's either something in my head or something that I'll sing to my kiddo or something, like Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. I try and pick a nice middle-of-the-road dynamic, either mezzo piano or mezzo forte, and I'm not using a lot of lip strength, just, again, just enough to create a buzz to wake the lips up. This is sort of the cup of coffee for my trombone playing, if you will. It sort of wakes my lips up, and it's just nice, easy songs, nice, easy pentascales, chromatic scales, diatonic scales, whatever you'd like to choose. Something nice and easy, and aim for a nice warm buzz as well. I center the mouthpiece right in the middle of my embouchure. That's what works best for me. Do what works best for you and feels most comfortable. You want to start every day of playing the trombone by centering your practice in a nice sort of comfort zone, you know, and work forward from there. A couple of other things I do to get started in this sort of beginning phases of buzzing is I do a lot of sirens. Trying to iron out any sort of skips and the partials. If you notice, whenever I came down that last time, it had a little bit of a skip. A partial jump. I'm gonna want to go back and iron that out. Making sure I'm reaching each end of the register, ironing out anything that doesn't feel comfortable or isn't coming easily. As you add different devices to the end of your mouthpiece, you'll notice that sometimes it adds partials. For instance, the longer lead pipes absolutely add partials. Work through them, iron them out, and you'll be stronger because of it. Uh. No partials. But whenever I first started with the longer lead pipe, there were a ton of partials, and I noticed that all I had to do was keep edging my way into where the breaks began and keep ironing those out until there were no longer breaks, and I could achieve one siren from my lowest note to my highest note and back down at a nice mezzo piano, mezzo forte dynamic. At this point, I usually move on to buzzing along with songs. At the end of this video, I'll include an example of a typical song that I'll buzz along to and some exercises that I use when buzzing along to these songs. But I usually start with four songs that just kind of get stuck in my head. These can be anything from classical to pop to country to alternative to classic rock, you name it. Really, it's anything that you're passionate about and that you want to sing and get out of your head, you know, so that it's fusing the connection between your ear to the lips to the mouthpiece, which will then transfer into what is essentially just a large megaphone, your horn. Some of the goals that I like to focus on whenever I'm buzzing is aperture control and dynamic control. I want to talk to you about each one of those individually. Aperture control is being able to keep a note steady because it's the choice to keep it steady. And that whenever you land on a note, you have the control to keep that aperture at that opening so that your lips buzz at the chosen frequency and it sustains for the period of time that you choose it to. That is the ideal goal for aperture control, is that you can play and buzz any pitch you want for as long as you want, as stable as you want. Pitches are determined by your aperture size, and so that's how this all kind of feeds into aperture control, leading into a lot of other different topics that we'll cover in other videos. Dynamic control was the other one. I use a lot of different dynamics whenever I buzz, but it's always a choice. I'll choose, all right, I'm gonna do this first fourth of this song, maybe minute and a half at mezzo piano. Then I'll do the second quarter of the song at mezzo forte. Then I'll move up to forte or fortissimo. Then I'll do the last part of the song, pianissimo, so that I'm working on dynamic control that is not influenced by range, to where I can buzz through the entire range of the instrument at whatever dynamic I choose, and that it's essentially, this is all working towards you being the master of your own instrument, and that I'm telling the trombone what to do, not the trombone telling me what to do or shaping the way I play, but rather I command it to play the way I want it to. I send information into the mouthpiece and it is amplified by the instrument. So buzzing every day is crucial for that exact reason, in that if I can do it on the mouthpiece, I can do it on the instrument. There's a lot of things that you can do on the instrument that you might not be able to do on the mouthpiece, but it will be stronger and sound better if you first accomplish it on the mouthpiece and then move it to the instrument. Whenever I buzz, I always like to aim for a nice, big, warm sound, regardless of the dynamic, mezzo forte. Even pianissimo. I'm aiming for a lot of, some might call it an airy buzz. I more think of it as warmth and just as big of a sound as possible, even in the softest dynamics to the largest dynamics, loudest dynamics. Again, just to sort of recap, you want to make sure you're always singing through the mouthpiece. You can include any sorts of attachments to add a little bit of resistance. Long lead pipe, short lead pipe, or a little bit of tubing on the end always helps. Moving to the mouthpiece on its own towards the end of your buzzing exercise will add strength and flexibility and versatility for whenever you move to the instrument itself. Remember, aperture control, dynamic control, making sure that you're really maintaining a solid solid pitch accuracy, rhythmic accuracy. Aim for all the same fundamentals that you aim for in your playing whenever you're doing your warm-ups on the horn, just make sure that it's a lot harder to control on the mouthpiece. Don't give yourself any slack. Be hard on yourself and aim for the best possible sound that you can at all times. Thanks for watching. See you soon. Hey everyone. Again, here's the video I promised of buzzing along to one of my favorite songs. Again, there's really no rules. Whichever line sort of sticks in your ear the most, buzz it. If you want to sing that line, sing it through the mouthpiece. Here we go. In addition to buzzing along to your favorite songs and sirens, you can also work at the piano to get better at buzzing. Start with some nice, easy pentascales. Making sure that you're extending your range both above and below your starting note. Also, a great exercise is going from one note to the next with your greatest sound possible and then connecting them. Our goal on the trombone is to always make our best sound on every single note. But first, you have to define what is your best sound on every single note. So, for instance, if we're going from C, middle C, to G, I want to first start by defining what is my best C sound like. Okay, what does my best G sound like? Okay, the exercise is as follows. C, G, C, G. Now connect them. And reverse it. Always aiming for your best sound from note to note as easily as possible. In addition to that, you can do octave sirens. Say, we'll choose D major. I want to imagine myself covering every single half step on the way up from D to the D above it, so that I'm not shortchanging any note along the way, that I'm getting my best sound possible on every single note. Listen again. Now notice I had to go back and iron out a few of those notes that weren't quite getting a full sound. That's A-okay, as long as you're getting that work done and the end result is a full sound on every single note, it'll transfer very well to the instrument. Those are the three great exercises to get you started. If you have any questions, feel free to email me at basebonebrian@gmail.com or respond to this in the YouTube comments below. See you soon. And why I buzz. First of all, I just want to... Ah, sucks.